Reliance Commercial Finance presents India SME Forum 2012. Find out the secrets of success in a series of seminars exclusively for smart entrepreneurs. Join India's biggest SME initiative to boost your business and celebrate SME achievers with India SME 100 Award.
Outside, I'd like to thank Vinod, Reliance, Ajay for introducing me well. I have a question for maybe panelists or the audience. Can anybody tell me what is the oldest industry in the world? I mean, I know, don't think otherwise, but the oldest industry in terms of where I belong to. The oldest industry, I'm sure you must be racking your brains, but the oldest industry is information industry. Now, the reason why I'm saying this is information industry is because earlier, you know, you used to have those pigeons carrying small notes with information between kingdoms before any formal source of information was developed. And then humans started spying. And in the 17th and 16th century, when the trade between various nations was more of agrarian, barter system used to be very prevalent. And even a small information which comes from a particular country about the availability of stock and what prices there should be would play an important role for a buyer to negotiate. Now, there used to be a messengers, a foot soldiers, who used to go to these countries to find out what is the situation. And these messengers used to get killed or arrested by those countries. Those pigeons used to get shot sometimes or killed. I'm also a messenger. When we do ratings, we actually do a messenger service. So if you get a bad rating, please do not kill me. I'm just passing on the information that I get from the market. I mean, one of my analysts in Dubai was arrested when I was in DNB. Not arrested by the police, but one of the local sheikhs got a bad rating. And he called our analyst and said, I want to meet you. The analyst went with utter innocence, saying that, okay, he wants to give me some gift because he's given a rating to him. Then he said, no, you are not able to go from here. You won't go from here till you give me a good rating from this. I'm sorry, it's a messenger services that we are doing, so we are just mirroring whatever we get from the market. With this anecdote, I would like to just start my presentation. I will take hopefully 15 minutes. What are the SME expectations? I'm sure earlier presenters have covered this. Timely credit, reasonably priced. The press articles I've seen lately are saying that reduce the interest rate. Mostly it's a clamor from the large corporates. SMEs, of course, need reasonably priced interest rates. But can they get interest rate as compared to corporates, a similar kind of rates? I doubt so. It will be a wrong aspiration. So reasonably priced. Adequate? Yes, because do you get adequate? Many times you don't get adequate credit because of various reasons. Lesser collateral requirement. Again, it is based on various factors which we will go to. But lesser collateral requirement also is a small amount of myth which is prevalent in the market. You have to pay sometimes 150% or 200% collateral. What are the challenges faced by the lenders? Now, there's a demand, there's a supply. As Suvik has correctly said, that the assessing the small and micro becomes a challenge. There are numerous SMEs. Compared to corporates, there are only few corporates falling into small sectors, 6 to 7 sectors. But SMEs fall into various kinds of sectors, difficult to assess. Geographically dispersed, Tirupur, Ludhiana, Jalandhar, Tuticorin. You come to east side, you have Haldia, Howrah. I mean, difficult to assess because they're geographically dispersed. There's also limited skill sets amongst the lending community to assess the SMEs. High NPAs historically and currently also. Lack of disclosure. There is not enough disclosure. Then you come to an important part called information asymmetry. I'm sure many of you must have heard this term. What is information asymmetry? You must be understanding, but from our perspective, what it means essentially is that the information, supply of information, there is irregularity. When we do assessment of companies, especially in the micro small, the supply of information is extremely irregular. When we ask for a net worth statement from the partners, we don't get it. We get it in an erroneous form. There's a to and fro communication. Sometimes the balance sheet which is supposed to be given to his wife comes to us. And that is erroneous because actually he wants to give a balance sheet which is supposed to be given to the IT authorities. Then we do a rating on a certain part and he says, please keep, don't release the rating because I've given you a wrong balance sheet. Now that is what I call supply of information. Reliability becomes an issue because, you know, financials are tweaked for a certain requirement. And hence the reliability becomes an issue, including the other documents. Now, the genesis of asymmetry is essentially inability or the willingness to share information. Now, sometimes people are unable. They are so dependent on chartered accountants or the consultants, they don't know what to give. There's a constant to and fro between the consultants and the SME. The time delays happen. And the willingness, of course. So it's a mix of inability and willingness. Lack of awareness, financial literacy, clarity, and technocracy. Some businesses are purely technocrats. They don't understand the commercial side. That becomes an issue. So if you see micro, small, medium, and large enterprises, this symmetry or asymmetry of information would vary. Micro, obviously, it will be difficult. As you go up the ladder, small, slightly better. Medium, much better. Large, don't have to say much. But this is the journey which I think we are also traversing with SMEs when we do ratings. Now, information asymmetry certainly leads to suboptimal credit decisions. I've encountered a lot of SMEs, they say, I've got a huge order book. I'm in the defense side. I'm supplying to BHEL and various other defense establishments. But I don't have cash. I don't have money. Now, what happens is the kind of information they give to the lenders is suboptimal, and hence, the credit decision taken by the lender because he doesn't understand the business. That is the reason why SME ratings have, we have seen for the last 7 years, have helped because we hire experts. We hire experts to know about that particular industry and put it into the financial and the commercial side. It is going to be able to reduce this asymmetry into this particular sector. Now, if you see this slide, which I'm trying to show it to you, and hopefully the last benches could see it, that we have 2.3 crore small and medium enterprises. Registered are about 15 lakhs in this country. Only 10% get funding from the formal sources, which I'm sure earlier presenter has covered it. And that's the unfortunate part. But is this going to change because we are doing ratings? I don't think so. It's going to change soon. So you'll have prevalence of high interest rates. Because it is risky to lend to SMEs who are not financially or commercially literate enough to come to a certain symmetry of information. What is a rating? It is basically the ability and the intention of the SME unit to meet his financial obligation in a given period of time. It's a distillation of information. It's like a funnel. You put all the information coming in from various sources, financial, non-financial, I'll come to that. And you get distilled version in a suffix, which is SME1, SME2, SME3, SME4, SME5, SME6. So SME1 being excellent, and as you go further down below, it is bad. It is assesses the discipline, the integrity, and the commitment level of the management. Three C's that we assess, the character, most important. The capacity of the person the bandwidth that he has to scale up, to network, to go out, to explore, to hire better advisors, and the ability to raise capital. These three C's we assess. Something about Smera I would like to tell you, people who don't know where we are coming from. We are a 7-year-old organization, floated by SIDBI, Dun & Bradstreet. To people who don't know, Dun & Bradstreet is an internationally renowned company which provides information for the last 165 years. It has a database of over 190 million companies worldwide. SIDBI, I don't think I have to introduce. It's an apex institution. And there are other government, public, private, multinational banks which are supporting us. We are the only rating agency dedicated for small, micro, and medium enterprises. These are various products that we offer. SME ratings, we recently got RBI approval for bank loan ratings, micro enterprise grading, bond and IPO grading, green ratings, which is for environmental purposes, MFI ratings, education institution ratings, maritime institution rating, risk management services. This is for the lending institution. We provide independent, comprehensive, and transparent. Independent because we have nothing to lose or gain by giving you good or bad ratings. We are a third party, unprejudiced. When a lender assesses, there could be some biases. Comprehensive because we cover everything. It's futuristic. It also looks at the historical perspective. And hence it is comprehensive. We look at management, we look at financials, we look at various other industry parameters. Transparent because it is shared with you before the ratings are released. And if you're unhappy, we discuss with you. There is a redressal mechanism that we have. If you are banking with a bank, you probably not know what is your rating, internal rating. This is the schema, which is what are the factors that go in, because you should know what are the factors we cover. Of course, financial parameters are important. But financial parameters are given weight for only 50% for obvious reasons, which of course has solvency ratios, liquidity ratios, how soon you can liquidate and pay your creditors. The non-financial parameters, we delve more on management quality, location advantage, networking, legal issues, industry and macroeconomic issues. Non-indicative, non-financial parameters, shareholding, age, legal crisis, management, marketing network, looking at management risk, business risk, and industry risk. We have done 18,500 ratings across the industry and India. We registered as a credit rating agency under SEBI and RBI. We have MOUs with 35 banks, with 14 banks extending interest rate subsidies, which means if you are rated well, which is SME 1, SME 2, SME 3, there are 14 banks you can go to and say, here is my rating from Smera, can I get 0.25 to 1% reduction in interest rate? We have a technical tie with Bangladesh Rating Agency. World Bank has acknowledged us internationally, and we are an important institution. Benefits that are accrued, that are accruing now after 7 years are both tangible and intangible. Tangible are enhancement of credit limits, 17%. We have done a survey, a dipstick study, about 500 well-rated SME Smera accounts. 17% has got reduction in enhancement of credit limits, reduction of interest rates, 21%, faster processing of credit application. Now it is slightly getting ingrained in the system. We hear bankers saying that you have Smera ratings, come to us. We will try and see how we can faster process your application. Reduction in security and loan conditionality, just 18 cases out of 500. But it is happening. Intangible benefits. Now, most of the people who come to us saying that I want only interest rate reduction, but many of them surprised us and surprised us well, saying that no, we are using it as a self-assessment tool. How do I look in the mirror? Like you go to a diagnostic center before you take insurance, and all of a sudden you are surprised that you have cholesterol and you have blood sugar, and you go to the insurance and say, yeah, sorry, your premiums go up. Now, what we are saying is check your health before. And then go to the lenders. So it's a self-assessment tool. improved morale of employees. When the employee knows that your company is well rated, he knows things are in good condition in the company. And he'll obviously say, tom-tom it to his family that we are a good rated company and to his friends. Improved image among peer firms, which is amongst his own industry. Improved terms with creditors. Enhanced brand image in the market. Improved profitability. And we have a dunce number that we give, DNB gives, which will help you in the international trade, because now with the FDI coming into multi-trade, multi-retail, all these Walmarts and IKEAs would come in. They have a dunce number ingrained into the system for processing your purchase order. Now, if you have a dunce number, the purchase order is released soon. If you don't, they will ask for it. We have this embedded into the rating. $1 of information creates $1,000 of credit. So if you have $1 of information on your company in the market, you get more credit. We believe in Smera that SME is an entrepreneur, and entrepreneurial skills are SMEs. SMEs currently depend only on the proprietor or partner, and hence, management evaluation becomes extremely important. That's why I'm dwelling about 5 minutes on this. What do we cover in management evaluation? We have basic educational qualification study of the entrepreneur. Professional experience, where does he come from? What's his background? Does he have experience in the same business? How well he's done in his professional career? Business attitude, we have heard a number of people say, well, I don't know what's my plan. I've started just like this. Not good business attitude. Motivation of carrying out the business. Why are you in business? What is your motivation? What brings you back next morning? Are you excited? Are you in commodity business? Are you getting value? Are you different? Business strategies. Sometimes strategies are very clear. Sometimes they are unclear. Level of control. Who controls? Only one person? Or you have graded controls below? Other businesses that you have. How are you? Is there an inter-company transaction? Is money coming from one company and going to the other companies? Overall organizational capability. Willingness to service loan, extremely important. As Suvik said that, look, CIBIL records, banker statement. This is typically projects the attitude of the entrepreneur. Vision and mission of the management. Profile of the advisors, and if you have board, who are these people? Are you taking their advice? Are you going out to seek advices? Are you paying for the advices? Many entrepreneurs don't want to pay. They want to get it free. But I've seen entrepreneurs who pay and get good advices and grow. Diversified experience skills. Organization structure, relationship between stakeholders, customers, suppliers, and other stakeholders. How are the relationships? Generation in the business, is it a first generation, second generation, or a third generation? What we have typically seen, that when a second generation comes, the passion for business reduces compared to the first generation. When the third generation comes, he kills the company. Many times, they migrate to US and they don't want to come back. And the first generation and second doesn't know what to do. We've seen some companies sunset because their children didn't come back and they're good businesses. And they did not promote anybody from within. We provide risk opinion through the cycle. We look at sectors, clusters, geographies, and rating categories, critical mass. We have access to proprietary models and lineage in evaluating the SMEs compared, you know, as SIDB and DNB supporting, mostly on SME segment. The objective is essentially to make SMEs go up the ladder from a micro, small, medium, and large enterprises and to a high symmetry with threefold advantages. Reduce information asymmetry. Provide insights for informed credit decisions to the lenders, comfort and unbiased third-party opinion. The rating journey for MSMEs has just begun, and I think it will lead to optimal lending and funding. Thank you so much.